What are you limping for?
I'm old. What do you think I'm limping for? I'm old, man. Damn. You ain't ever seen an old person before?
I'll be like, yeah, boy. What are you doing, bro? What is wrong with you, man? Yeah. Wait, did I register this? I think I did.
I'm at 3,000 right now. In Panorama.
Make sure I did it, though. No. This can cast it. Ready. Alright. Now let's do. I gotta change my guy's age. Oh. Gonna give him. '59. How old would that be if he's born in 1959? Oh, this thing does not turn, bro. What's wrong with you old, you young people over here? What's your problem, man?
I can go hunt and kill Adam. Was that you?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's you because you read that stuff.
I don't know if he saw that. He probably saw it. I'm driving with all my lights on right now. This thing does not move at all. It's so slow.
So he said that we can go and call off you and start shooting our guns if we want. We just can't shoot any animals, so. Hey, if a cop said we could do it, we could do it, bro.
Yeah. Where's my old man walk? I need to find my old man walk.
I use Lester and Lester too.
Lester. Yeah, I'm gonna use Lester.
Wow, copycat. I'm playing.
Shut your mouth, bro.
So what are you playing? Just going slow on the roads?
I'm gonna just break all the traffic laws. Pack it.
Okay. I just did a jank drift in front of a cop. He didn't care. He just honked his horn at me. Where are you
at? I'm an old man. How no, you doing, not. Bro?
But you are now. Oh, there you are.
Hey, get off my ass, boy. What are you doing? You're probably putting on one call.
Listen here, little twat. Okay, that card's pristine. Oh, you're a fellow old man. You're so twat.
Hey, shut the fuck up, bro.
No, you know you're so twat. Hey, man, that's my car. Listen, you little twat, it's my car. Don't hit my car.
Hey, get out of my way, bro. Get out of my way. Where are you, man?
You twat. You get hit out my way. Car. You old geezer.
Who you calling geezer, boy?
You're the
I'm
geezer,
older
boy.
Than you. I'm older than you.
Yeah, that's why I'm calling you a geezer, you oldie.
Yeah. Get fucked, kid. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you?
Get away from me.
Why are you geezing me, geezer?
Nah! Boy! You are trying to control by.
Hey! Come here!
But do these cops not even care?
What cop? I don't see what.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, do you not even care? Like, they're not even responding to the 911 call.
I know, right?
Okay, you little geezer, you better put it on and give me insurance before I insurance fraud you.
You, I got a chainsaw in the back of my vehicle. You want some, boy?
I got a pistol in the back you of my car. You want some?
I don't care about your dumbass pistol. I've been through Vietnam.
I've been through. Oh, shoot!
It's a geezer. What's wrong with you, boy?
Who's that? Oh, is it Josh, probably?
You just made the shit out of your car.
I should probably pull over. He's pulling me over. Hold up.
Fuck you!
He's coming after you!
For what? Okay. I didn't do shit.
He said, I said you hit my car, now you're driving away. He said, stay right here. And hell no, I ain't staying here.
He didn't know where he went, though.
Damn, he's coming back to me. Shoot.
Yeah, he doesn't know where he went.
Damn it, Chad.
I don't know how they lost this thing.
I don't know. You're going so slow.
Bro.
Oh,
I really don't know how they lost this thing.
Oh, they're calling units in code 3. What the hell? I got pulled over by a fortune. Probably Josh.
Definitely Josh. It's all marked, so it's Josh.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, dumb motherfuckers. Wrong with them? They're looking for me. Damn, kids. Dumbass kids.
I don't know how they don't know where I am. I don't know how I got away from that. Bro, that was crazy.
Oh, I told him about the chainsaw.
That what?
That you have a chainsaw in the back of your vehicle and you threatened me with the chainsaw.
Well, I would tell him that you're trying to shoot me.
Fucking fuck.
Oh, is that you?
Yeah.
So did you call 911?
No, I ain't calling 911.
Okay.
What you looking at Sheila for?
I swear to God.
God damn dumb mother.
These are a one
stupid people. Stupid, stupid, stupid.
You're literally just on the street from where they stopped me. Yeah. Literally, you're like two blocks down.
And they took so long to find me. Stupid, stupid, stupid.
Are you
dumb kids?
He's going to activate medic. Man. Oh shoot!
Dumbass.
What? Why is the three cops here? What the hell? That's pretty much Josh. Josh is leaving to activate medic.
What do you want? What do you want?
Don't talk to me.
For what? What do you want?
I pin hit and run on you.
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Wait, what?
What are you say? Limping for?
You look old.
Okay.
What do you think I'm limping for? I'm old, man. Damn. You ain't ever seen an old person before? Asking me dumb questions. Damn.
Alright, come and talk to me, please.
Come talk to you for what? I ain't do none.
You may have done something.
I ain't do none.
Okay, well, I have reports of you doing a hit and run back there in a red truck.
I didn't hit nobody, that mother... that dude hit me.
What about the damage?
Look back here. Look. Come on, boy. Come on, sonny boy. Let me show you something.
Alright, so what?
See right here? You see this paint that's deposited on my bumper? He hit Sheila, man. He hit Sheila. A man ran into the back of me. Then he started to chase me all the way down and hit me on the side of my truck. So I hit him back. Dumb kids nowadays, man.
Alright, so well, I have an officer who I witnessed you hitting it. So, first of all, before we go any further, this is a very nice paramedic who's gonna check you out.
That officer is dumb. He didn't see me hit shit. He came in the middle of the end of what happened. That guy chased me all the way up Panorama to Yellow Jack and all the way back down here. And then I cut across from Joshua Road onto Alhambra. And then I almost hit a cop, and then that guy kept running into the back of me. I'm sure that cop saw that, right? Why did he see me hit the other guy, huh? These dumb cops be so selective with their vision.
Alright, you're gonna have to come over here, please. Don't get in the vehicle, man.
Sir, I'm Assistant Chief Knuff. How you doing?
I'm doing too good. Look at my Sheila, man. Got some ugly red paint all over it, my bumper stink. This car, I had this car since 1969. My dad gave this to me. Look at it, now it's ruined. Now it's ruined.
We did get a call, you know, minor 1050, you know, everything. I just want to check you out, make sure you're okay.
Are you okay with that? I gotta take my blood pressure medicine.
Alright, so do you not need medical?
Nah, I'm good. Gotta take my blood pressure medicine. That's it.
Alright, do you always walk around with that lamp?
Yeah, I'm old. And I fought in the Vietnam War.
Should you not have a walking stick or something?
Alright, Rob, I guess I'll
need no. I need no stick to help me walk.
Okay.
Friction.
My butt hurts. My butt hurts.
Alright, so I'm gonna actually get the officer who witnessed the 1050 down here, or should I say the crash down here, and we're gonna sort it out, okay?
Okay. Whatever you say, bud.
Yeah. You didn't stick nothing on me, Dave.
Shut up.
They're back on you now.
I can tell because the medic just rolled up back at station.
Yeah, they're on
you. And now there's two cop cars coming this way, so.
Mm-hmm. And boys on you.
What story did you make up, huh? What story did you make up?
I said that you rear-ended me and then you followed me all the way up to Yellowjack and all the way back. And then I hit you after you hit me in the back of my car and my side of my car, and then I hit you back over there. That's when I came home and smacked the shit out of my gate.
Alright, well, some of you here may as well go ahead and grab your story, so tell me what happened.
I just told you my story, man. Weren't you listening?
To be honest with you, I was more concerned about your health and what you were doing with your vehicle, so I kind of... It's not that I wasn't listening, it's just I didn't get the full story.
You young people don't be listening to nothing nowadays. Alright. First thing. Right, let me tell you.
They arrested me for no license when I do have a license. It's weird.
Right. I was coming out from the Panorama Drive on this side, going all the way across the railroad track. Hey. And then this guy decided.
Yeah.
Then this guy decided he's gonna run into the back of my car.
Your MDT now. It might be.
What do you say?
And
can
then
you him to across the street, please.
And then I went forward a little bit, give that man some space, cause he ran into the back of my car. I assume it was a mistake and he started honking his horn at me.
Where was this again?
That was after the railroad tracks, going that way.
Okay, so he rammed into you.
Yeah, he rammed into the back of my car, man. My Sheila. And then he chased me all the way up to Yellowjack. I made a U-turn, came back over by the sheriff's station. That's where I saw some guy in a black car, and the guy turned on this blue and Christmas tree lights. So then I turned around and I smacked that boy real good, and then I came back here.
Okay, and you understand that hitting him and leaving is a hit and run, right?
I was in a hit and run, but he hit me first, and he started to pit me. And smashed the crap out of my car. I was defending myself.
Well, sir, if you notice, he's over there in the backseat of a cop car also. And I was the one you guys passed right there in the black Charger. That was me. I tried to get you guys to stop, but yet you guys both kept on leaving and not wanting to stop.
Nah, he was chasing me down. He was ramming in my car. So why would I stop when he's ramming in my car? You want me to die or something?
For me, when you guys made that right, you hit straight into his passenger. I mean,
yeah,
his back right.
Yeah, because he finally gave me a space to turn around, so I was defending myself.
Alright, sir, can you go ahead and stand up for me?
For what?
For now, you're possibly going to be under arrest for hit and run. However,
so
you're
going to put handcuffs on an old man with a bad foot and a bad back. That's what you got to do.
Right now, I'm saying at least reckless on them both.
And y'all really need four cops for one old man with a bad back and bad foot.
Well, when you guys are driving around like maniacs over there, acting like the Indianapolis 500, yeah.
In my prime, I would take on all four of y'all. Back in Vietnam, we had those little boys come over here. They're gonna jump out the bush and try to get you. The trick is to not let them get you. You gotta know where they're gonna come from, right? Nowhere
sir,
to get a new. You can take
very
out all of them.
You know,
sir,
you
stand
know,
up.
I
got my
M14. I have a guy in the cell who also was in the Vietnam. He was arrested a couple days ago, and he's still there. Maybe you can share stories.
Oh, you just rude. You ain't got no respect for your elders, boy.
All right, can you
better watch
building,
it,
please?
Come on, where's the car? Where's the car? Don't put no cuffs on me. You're gonna hurt my hands, man. Don't put no. All right, where's
I'll
the car?
I'll make him loose.
Here, look. I ain't got none in my pockets.
We'll put him in my RAM.
My wallet's right. In the truck. If you need that, don't put no cuffs on me. Don't put no cuffs on me. Am I going in here?
It's your call. Do you want to put cuffs on him?
Right now, let's just get him in the car until we get stuff completely figured out right now. Has he been violent towards you at all?
Me? No, no. He's just been minding his own business, doing his own stuff.
Alright, so really no reason to even put him in cuffs. I have a case, so he ain't gonna put no damage towards me.
Okay, so what do you want to do? I mean, he's technically dead, although he did hit him.
I gave him such a hard time.
He, you know, he was by a cop, he could have stopped and talked to you.
They're both going for at least reckless driving.
Of course, I think they should both go for hit and run, because with the way the bumper's bent inwards, and the way the paint is sitting on the vehicle, it gives me reason to believe the other guy did a little bit of hit and run as well.
Alright, let's hit them both, and they can fight this in court. Hit them both with reckless driving and a hit and run. They could fight it in court. This guy is saying that the other guy hit him, he was defending himself. That's what a lawyer is made for. So we can sit there and let them fight.
Nobody got time or money to get a lawyer. You see where I live, boy? Chad, I live in this old little bungalow.
Did you base your Discord votes off Naruto?
Sir, I've treated you respect. I don't have you in cuffs. I have you spaced.
You're
not saying
it's making a lot more sense after I started watching
it. I gotta read to you.
And I really like
you have the
Naruto.
Right to remain silent. Anything you say cannot be used against you in the court of law. If you don't have a attorney, we'll be present at any time of question. Do you understand your rights?
Yeah.
Alright, like I said, I put you in a spacious area so you have room for your feet. I'm not putting you in cuffs. So I'm gonna try to treat you with as much respect as possible if you do the same with me. I'll transport this one down.
Alright.
Ernie, if you get off.
Yeah, I based those off of Naruto and all that. You're probably in talk.
Wait, you're being arrested too?
Yeah.
Ha, you suck.
No, but he saw me hit you, so they said hit and run.
Oh, that's perfect. Well, I
where's
not really hit and run.
Are they taking me directly to the prison?
Are they?
Maybe.
Well, don't do that for, like, high-value prisoners. We should do that.
I don't know.
Like, prison tech.
Wait, y'all need Elio or Sif?
Oh, Bradley's here, what the hell?
You might have to go save with Dave here.
Okay.
Cause
he doesn't
mind,
right? Wait, how long you got left in your timer? Priority.
Oh yeah, I should have been out already 11 minutes ago.
Oh, so we got channel switched. 29 minutes left on the clock for the next priority.
No, you can do a priority. No.
Oh. Sir, what is your name?
He's saying his priority.
My wall's in the truck. My name is Jason Cassidy. Better not forget it.
I'll go sip though. That's no problem.
Bro, I'm so beat.
Mr. Cassidy, I think I've had a couple run-ins with you before.
I don't know, you probably in another world or something. I know I never talked to you before.
Was it just tough going back to work, or did y'all have a crazy day?
Nah, I'll explain when I'm finished recording.
Then maybe I've heard your name come across dispatch.
Wait, bro, they're taking me straight to the prison. What the hell?
It's because you're important, Dave.
Bro, it's Ernest. He's not important in any way, shape, or form.
Ernest, there it is.
He can hang out with Arthur.
Have you ever been to this fancy place?
Is he? Oh.
No.
Yeah, he's still in prison.
I don't know what this is.
He's probably still in solitary after he got jumped.
Yeah, they were talking about him. They were like, We got this guy that was in the Vietnam War. He was in solitary. You can probably go have a conversation
before
about
you
it.
Get him out. Let me get.
Wait, are they there right now?
First?
Yeah.
Are y'all there right now?
Yeah. You wanna come? You wanna come?
I'm about to show up. I'm about to show up.
All right, bet.
All right, come this way, Mr. Caster.
I'm in my jumpsuit.
Oh wait, you can't walk that fast, man. I ain't that fast no more. Damn. My back hurts. Am I going in here?
Yes, sir.
Alright, which area are y'all in?
I'm just coming through the lobby.
We're in Grand Sonora.
Go through that door and then
the
make the first
pop
left
area.
To the next
door. Is
that
where they're gonna put him?
Is Micah not gonna take me out?
No, they wait until I get put in.
Alright, go up against that right there so we can get your picture in here.
Nah. I ain't the prettiest anymore. You know, back in the day, bro, I had all the ladies.
So
I had about three, four, five bitches, you know.
Gen Pop area.
Alright, come over here to this table.
Yeah, going to Gen Pop, yeah.
Yeah, that's where I was at. That's where I'm sitting right now.
I assume we're gonna be checking the booking and then Gen Pop.
Yeah, I'm getting booked right now.
This is so funny. I'm just sitting here. I look pissed.
All right, so now we got your pants. You can go ahead and go through that door right there.
Can I wipe my hair, man? This like thing's dirty as shit.
Like a small Leo thing?
Yes, sir. If you want to wipe it.
Like for all departments, here, or you like can go ahead DOC.
Do it in the sink yourself.
Just like book people if they want. That's if you have, you know, enough of both Civ and Leo.
I kind of want to pretend to break out.
I want to cheat, but I don't think we can with the con. Well, you might. Yeah,
am I going to the right place?
I can.
No, I can't.
Yes, sir, just keep on walking straight.
There's only what, 6 Leo on right now.
That's a lot for a breakout.
That's true. As long as I don't kill anybody.
Mm-hmm.
I'm coming in now to the.
Yeah, they're bucket. Oh yeah, they're. I'm right behind you. Are they not gonna print me? Okay, I'm good.
I guess
take left.
I'm good with that, bro. I'm not gonna be on their arrest record then.
All right, first cell right here on your left.
Will. If you don't push me.
Hey, get the fuck away from me, boy! I'll beat your ass out of here.
Hey, it's Arthur. It's Arthur.
Ernest, my man, how's it going?
You know this motherfucker. This dude got me arrested. I'm gonna beat his ass.
Hopefully you're...
Oh, don't worry. Hey, I know you.
Hey, I know you.
One sec, where...
There it is.
Dang, they let you out of solitary?
Yeah, they did. Right, they transferred those other jokers into some maximum security stuff.
Well, good. I hope you stay safe in here.
Shut up, Ernest. I'll come talk to you in a second. I'm gonna beat.
You're gonna do what? What you say, boy?
I want you talking to you, old man.
I'll bust your face, boy. None of you motherfuckers better come around me. You'll get the full fury of
ain't
the old U.S. Army.
Dead,
I'm a former Marine, boy. Don't even come around me with that shit. No, I caught the.
You got jailed right as I was.
You good? Yo, you good?
Knowing this, my voice is crippling, bro.
Dude, I don't know why I'm used to it so much.
Oh, that's crazy. Oh, I'm coming back like this, bro. Are they still there?
No, they're walking out.
Bro, I was gonna come Wait, back.
Did they not jail?
Hold up. Oh, they're not gonna jail me, bro.
Not jailing Dave.
Hold on. I'm coming back. Cause I got released, right? Yeah, bitch. You talking about my hairline, my hairstyle, boy?
Oh Lord, it's even worse than before.
Worse than before, by you.
Hey, those are my glasses.
I don't care about your glasses, boy. Hey, you motherfucker, you got me in here.
Oh,
you
shit.
You got me in here.
No.
Get
down. Get down. This is the Vietnam War special.
The Vietnam War special.
It's called Tackle and Jackal.
Tackle and Jackal.
What is this?
I'm talking to you. I don't fuck to you. Why am I in this? Come here, you old geezer. I ain't talking to you. Come here, you old geezer.
Big crap. Start looking around.
Hey! Oh, shoot!
First thing, you deserve that.
Hey, man, we got in the car's
lock. Take his gun from him.
Where do we go? Get his taser. I got the taser.
Alright, try this locker room over here.
Oh, wait. Hold on.
I got the taser. Who wants the taser?
Right, I'm gonna go grab his nightstick.
Alright, this is a priority, so we should.
Channel switch. Aw, damn, dude, I can't use the taser against any of the cops. But I can do it against.
Alright.
Oh, why you punch me, you old man?
I got it. I'm in.
Oh, we got a big boy.
Yeah, let's take him into the room and lock him in there. Let's go. I'll help you. I'll help you, Arthur. Let's go.
Here,
you old geezer.
Bro, the
hey, get in that shell.
Work.
Get in that shell.
Get in the shell, you under a wish.
The,
I'm not gonna do nothing. I'm not gonna do anything.
Go get the keys from him, and so we can lock the door.
Who has the keys?
Jason, don't you over here?
Jason, do you have the keys?
Your name is Jason, right?
It's a cop! It's a cop!
Come near me, though.
He's got a gun.
Why is he shooting me?
That's me that's shooting. They thought that you had a gun.
I'm running, dude. I'm out.
You said exit that, bro.
Just run.
I'm out.
Oh, I got shit on. Okay, I got shit.
Dude, I didn't think they were gonna respond that fast.
Dude, bro, I didn't know they were there already, bro. I didn't know they were there.
I turned around and saw Rob.
Wait, I can't taste the cops, so I can do is run.
Me with
me.
Help me.
Oh, I'm gone.
Go. Don't reach for him. Don't you dare reach for him.
They got my gun, my nice tech, everything.
I don't want to get out of here. Oh my god. Yo, I legit don't know how to get out of here.
Security officer, get the officer at the jail cell.
Are you dead, Chad?
Yeah. They took me down.
Oh shoot. I don't know how to get out of here.
Who's all beating me right now? Is that Frankie?
Yeah, they got my handcuffs, everything.
Okay. Oh, dude, right, I would have tased him so good, but I think I broke my contact level.
Was it all three of them to jump you? As long as you didn't fire it at him. I don't think
I was the one firing. They thought that your thing was a gun, and then as soon as I heard say he got a gun, I started shooting from inside the office.
Oh, like two of them shot two bullets at me. But they
missed. Because they thought your taser was a gun.
Alright, let me. Need a medical attention.
I think you broke your contact.
Yeah.
Alright, let me get some med.
I just gotta get out of here, dude. I don't know where I'm going.
Damn, bro.
They're gonna probably have to search the entire place at the place.
Oh, I see. No, I don't.
They know what door I took off out of, but they don't know any type of
trick. Because we took out the same door. There's only one door. But you're in the courtyard now, right?
No, I'm on the outskirts. I'm just looking for a door out of here.
You got stabbed. Well, come Josh on, got stabbed. Right,
come here, deputy.
I didn't get stabbed or
anything.
Dude,
how did you get here so quick?
Yeah, he hit me with something in the back of my head.
Like, they got here like within a minute.
Sit down over here.
Micah could have been sitting in the parking lot doing your paperwork.
Yeah, probably.
That's true. But still, like, everyone else got at the same time.
Use that medical bone.
Alright, I'm going to try and run out the front door. Y'all think that'll work? It's got to. I think it will.
All I know is, you know, I had to work some OT, so I looked out that glass window right there, and I see two inmates fighting, so, you know, calling it in over the radio. Hold on. Step out to go help break it up, and then boom. I don't know nothing else. Like, I got hit in the back of the head.
Is there anybody at the front?
Bro, they're like... Bro, Frankie literally tackled me and then beat me while I was on the ground. That's the
difference. Like, get down.
Or something like that.
Well, I did point the taser at him.
You want me
I was expecting to get
give
shot,
me your
but, you know,
your tie, you have a tie.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna listen to what they're saying.
Hold on. I'll get my personal belt here.
Alright, guys, well... There you go, Jason Cassidy's stirring up trouble again. Thank you guys for joining me on this episode of Diverse Roleplay. Thank you for all the love, all support, everything that you guys have showed me on these videos. I really do appreciate everything that you guys have done for me. But we're gonna head out now. I have some sleeping to do, I already gotta keep up with my doctor's orders. So, but with that being said, thank you guys again. Really appreciate it. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day. Have a great week. Peace, y'all.